to notice when the shepherd finds the lost sheep. Notice what he does. The text says he rejoices. The shepherd didn't curse out the sheep. He didn't beat the sheep. He didn't tie up the sheep and brutally drag it back to the sheepfold. Nor did he say to the sheep, how many times am I going to have to go out here searching for you? No! Who has intentionally or unintentionally lost their way, the believer's role, I'm not talking about what you think you ought to do, the believer's role based on the word of God is to lovingly accept them back into the fold. When you find the lost sheep, don't bring up everything they did in the past. Don't try and browbeat them down. Don't focus on too many questions of where have you been. Now, that doesn't mean that you don't exercise some caution and do some fact checking on what they say they're going to do or not going to do or what they're going to stop doing. We ought to be harmless as a dove, but be wise as a serpent. But whatever we do, it should be motivated by love to help a person come to confession and repentance of sins so they can return and be restored back to God and be placed back on their path that God has in store for them. There are people who want to come back to the church. They've been out in the world for a long time and they finally realize that they can't make it without Jesus. But we are not going to attract them to come back to the church if they think all they're going to get when they come back from the church is some ugly looks. Be the subject of gossip. In your conversation that says, I know there's not he or she back up in the church house. Or can you believe he or she is wearing that to church? We must learn to rejoice over the fact a lost sheep has been found, and then we love on them, pray with and for them, disciple them, and allow the word of God and the Holy Spirit to shape and mold them to be what God created them to be. Church, do you still? I just wonder sometimes, do the church still believe that the name of Jesus and his word has life, transformational power? I wonder, do we still believe that in the name of Jesus and his word, there is destiny, rearranging power, miracle working power? Do you still believe that Jesus can save, that he can heal, that he can deliver, that he can make free? Then start going out into the hearts. Start praying for God to identify lost souls to you. And then after God identifies lost souls to you, intercede on their behalf. Pray for God to open up their heart and their spiritual eyes to who Jesus is. Then you invest in them by discipling them. Share with them your testimony of how you got saved. Share with them your testimony of how God came and rescued you while you were being a lost sheep. And then invite them. Invite them to join you in your Bible study class. Whether it is on Wednesday night with the pastor or with your Sunday morning Bible study class. Invite them to join you on SHOP, the Sweet Hour of Prayer, every Tuesday night. Invite them to join you online. Be a part of your watch party online. Invite them to go to the support and resource tab on our